Foi fácil, foi uma decisão fácil, vendo o poderio que tem a Juventus.
It can't have been easy for Madrid to let this man go. Any team would miss Cristiano Ronaldo. But few teams have lost as many huge players as Real Madrid. Here are six players Real Madrid should never have let go. Number one, Cristiano.
Ha hecho una historia brillante en el Real Madrid. Fue un club que me ayudó en todo. Pero esta es una nueva etapa en mi vida.
You know we've got to start with the legendary CR7. He left Madrid on top with his fourth UCL win for the team and fifth overall. Many people felt that at 33, Ronaldo's best days were behind him. But he's shown just the opposite.
The age is not important. I feel good. I feel motivated. Exciting.
Madrid have needed a goal scorer, and Cristiano is providing the goals in Turin. They may still win La Liga this year, but that's something they weren't able to do for a while after letting this next guy go. Number two, Makalele.
I think Real Madrid is Real Madrid, you know.
Claude Makalele was never the most glamorous Madridista. And that's exactly why he was sold to Chelsea. Madrid had adopted what was then known as the Galacticos policy. And Madrid's president wanted to make room for one of the world's most glamorous stars, David Beckham. But Makalele was so important to Madrid's balance. He put in a lot of effort and covered the gaps to allow the other Galacticos to shine. That's why when Makalele left, Zidane had big questions. Why put another layer of gold paint on the Bentley when you're losing the entire engine? Makalele went on to shape some of the best Chelsea teams of all time. And speaking of a former Chelsea player, number three, Robin.
Ich weiß auch, ich war natürlich auch in Madrid und ich weiß, dass La Decima.
Robin could have been at Real for this UCL win. The winger with one move that works every single time joined Madrid from Chelsea and immediately got to work carving up defenses. But just two seasons in, Madrid went big on new Galacticos, Kaká and Cristiano. Robin's playing time dried up. And in the end, Robin said he was forced out of Madrid, even though he wanted to stay. And speaking of Dutchmen, number four, Seedorf.
Real Madrid es uno de los favoritos.
Seedorf is one of the most versatile and underrated players in history. He won UCLs with three different clubs. He was a player that could have played anywhere in midfield or attack. But his own compatriot, Goose Hiddink, gave him less playing time, which led him to leave for Inter Milan. And speaking of Inter Milan, number five, Hakimi. It seems Madrid have lost another starlet to Inter. Hakimi spent two incredible years at Dortmund, but instead of returning to fight for a first-team place at Los Blancos, the young Moroccan has signed with Antonio Conte's project in Milan. It could prove a big loss for Real, as Hakimi is arguably the biggest right wing back prospect in the world. In a few years, Madrid could be having big regrets. Maybe even as big as they felt with number six, Schneider. Well, well, well. If it isn't yet another player who went from Madrid to Inter. The difference here is Schneider went on to deserve a Ballon d'Or at Inter. The Dutchman had an incredible year in 2010. He won the treble in Italy and made the World Cup finals with the Netherlands. When he left Madrid, no one expected him to be so successful. But that's exactly what happens when Real Madrid try to ship out incredible talents. Real Madrid can have a few regrets in recent years. They've won a lot of Champions Leagues, but that doesn't mean they've been perfect. They've let some of the greatest players of all time slip through their fingers. We didn't even mention Özil, Cambiaso, or Di Maria. And they even let some of their legends like Casillas or Raul go without the honors they deserved. Who do you think should be Real's biggest regret? Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave us a like and please subscribe to the channel. Now, the voice is yours. Give us your ideas for new videos in the comments.